Hey, everybody, it's Evicta's Time to Teen Eating Streak here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for the support. Destroying the like streak goal yesterday. In less than 8 hours, we got over 3,000 likes and a whole lot of comments. Thank you all very, very much. Here's your meme of the day. Not really a meme of the day. It's a screenshot of the day. This one brought to you by Mordekalim or Mordekalim, or maybe Mordekalim, on this Invicta subreddit. And the title of the thread was, "Now my island has everything I need, little heart." And yes, indeed, your island has been blessed by Sissy. Beautiful. Well done. Thank you all very much. I'll talk about the two-year streak in a second, but first, get to your, oh good, Whiskey Kilo 4 November 1 Romeo November 7. We've got just god-awful everything except for maybe movement speed. Well, no, our tears rate's kind of okay, I suppose. But, of course, our biggest problem is the fact that we're starting on Curse of the XL and the fact that, oh yeah, we have 2.71 damage. Now, 2.71 damage is bad. There's no question about it. It's not good. Combined with the fact that we've got Pop here, Pop is not one of my favorite tier effects ever. We've got a little bit of a it's a little spicy, I gotta say. We need to be cautious about taking Red Heart damage. Obviously, we don't want to lose our deal with the devil. Given the fact that, again, we have a tier effect that I'm not necessarily a huge fan of. Although Pop can be quite good, it really depends on what is thrown into the mix of things here. If you can get a high tier delay, or I should say, if you can get a high rate of fire, low tier delay, Pop can do great work. The problem is that you normally don't have the combination of the two. And again, really where the danger lies in this run is just, starting with Curse of the XL is not terrible. In fact, I've gone on record and we'll echo the sentiment that if you want to start, if you have to have only one start or one floor on any given run as an XL floor, you want it on the first floor. You just do. Now, this is also interesting here because, well, I think Tech 2 would end the streak. I'm just going to be honest. I think that me taking Tech 2 there would actually be the end of the streak, because Tech 2 is an automatic 30% damage down just across the board, and we already don't do a whole lot of damage. The only upside to taking Tech 2 in that spot would have been the fact that we don't have to worry about Pop anymore. So, yeah, but I think that with our base damage being so low and for us getting just basically a blank item in there, we can't take Tech 2. Tech 2 used to be good. It used to be real good. It was one of the premier carry items in the original Isaac. But in Rebirth, it's just so bad. So bad. Even if you have a ton of damage with Tech 2, you're not going to be really pushing up the damage meters. You're certainly not going to impress anybody. No one's going to be impressed by Tech 2's DPS. I can just tell you that right now, brother or sister. So talking about yesterday's run, not really the run so much as just the significance. It was our, technically speaking, I guess some people were saying, oh, it's a leap year. I wasn't sure if people were actually trolling or not. I mean, I know it was a leap year, but like, come on, guys. 365 days in a normal year times two, it's 730. But yes, indeed, we crossed the two-year mark of the Eden Streak, and it didn't really sink into me at the time. In fact, I didn't even mention it in yesterday's video, just because I don't look at the numbers like that. Those aren't the win streak number is not the important one that I even truthfully think about all that much, ever. You know, it's gotten to the point where the routine is just. I'm not going to say that I'm getting bored of winning. I'll never get bored of winning. I don't want to ever stop winning. However, it's just that, like, with the days that they run together, and I record so many videos every single week that none of them really stand out from each other. Like, they're not made to be like, oh, this one was such a unique and awesome run. You're like, you know, I remember that win. I really don't. I remember some of the good wins, not all of them. You know, if you ask me, hey, Invicta, what happened in that last time you had this item and you could have done this, but you didn't, and you did that, and I'm like, dude, I have no idea what you're talking about. I have absolutely no clue. I see a lot of references being made. This could be a key. Not a key. I see a lot of references made in callbacks and stuff in Twitch chat a lot, and of course on the subreddit. Of people asking me, why did I do this on this particular day? And the answer is, I don't remember doing it. I really don't. It's a combination of, I think, my of, like I said, my workload that I do every single week and every single... I mean, I play Isaac a lot, you know. Which some people aren't going to believe because they're like, actually, Victor, I came by your stream and you never play Isaac. Look, you gotta... The only time I play Isaac on stream for the scheduled streams, which is Wednesday through Saturday, is at the... It's the first segment. Isaac is always the first segment. So if you're not there on time, you're going to miss Isaac. Now, I have been known to randomly go back to Isaac, but that's a total random, though. Most of the time, it's on a late-night stream, and I'm just, like, I'm tired of playing, like, you know, whatever gacha game I'm playing, or I'm tired of playing Path of Exile or something like that. Lately, it's Animal Crossing, but I don't think I'll ever get tired of playing Animal Crossing right now. Who would have thought that that was going to be the game to derail everything? You know, I was, like, I was hip-deep in Path of Exile, about to work on my second character because I just got an Exalt drop. Those of you who don't play Path of Exile, none of this is going to mean anything to you. I was full bore. I was trying to make sure that didn't happen, but whatever. You know, I was going in guns blazing with the new character and everything, and I've got a build that I was going to play, all this stuff, and then Animal Crossing comes along. I'm like, yeah, who's going to care about Animal Crossing? I don't care about Animal Crossing at all. Animal Cross this is what I was going to say. But then I realized that there's an economy side to it, and I talked about it in yesterday's run. It's taken a hold of me in a way that I was not expecting. In a good way. I mean, it's pleasantly surprising that Animal Crossing is so enjoyable to play. I'm only doing this just to lock in the devil deal. Precedent here. Shade isn't good. In fact, I'll talk about why it's a terrible item here in a second. Now, I know that it's going to upset some people that I didn't take Head of the Keeper. This is not the reason why I'm taking it, though. The reason why I'm taking it is because we actually need money in this run. So, Growth Hormones, of course, is a huge help, but we're going to need a lot more help than Growth Hormones in terms of damage for us to catch back up here. So the reason why Shade is terrible is basically because I found out over the weekend, I found it out on stream actually, that Shade can actually be destroyed by the game. That's right, you heard me right. Shade can actually be destroyed by the game. What will happen is that Shade will turn into like three or four of the black grubs, like the larva, the shadow grubs. And once they're basically the ones that you get whenever you have My Shadow, that item. And those charmed grubs will, like, you know, they do some damage, contact damage, and that's it. And once they're gone, they're gone. Shade doesn't come back at all. Like, Shade's just gone, making it one of the most useless, pointless items in the entire game. Because it's a one-time, like, once it's gone sort of a thing, you know? It's not like you can gain any sort of lasting benefit. You don't get any stat from Shade. It's there, and then if it takes too much damage, it's literally gone for good. It's like, okay, well, that's a solid item. Sure hope there's more of that in Rebirth. By Rebirth, I mean Repentance. But Animal Crossing's really good. It's given me a chance. I didn't realize that it was a social game. And, like, I met up with Toaster Woman, who is going to be... She'll be the future Mrs. Krendor. She visited my island. She was my first ever island visitor. She gave me like a cherry tree. She gave me some pears, gave me some peaches. I mean, oh, it was awesome. And I was like, oh my gosh, like people on your friends list can like come to you and bring you stuff. You can trade stuff. I was like, this is great. And then I started imagining stuff. I'm like, man, what if there was like an underground black market for Animal Crossing stuff. You know, I'm not sitting here trying to perpetuate that I'm going to do anything like that. But it does get you thinking. I'm always looking as an entrepreneur. I'm like, I smell capitalism in the work. Tom Nook, you're not the only one who can make money here, sort of thing, you know. I'll give you 50 turnips for your light up your light up Isaac doll that you made. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Letourneau. It's going to be as 150 for you, the Canadian tax. And I found out what the I found out that there's the Mystery Island tour, which is something that I was not privy to until yesterday. And what it is it is a it's a randomly generated island that you can fly to. It's not a one-way trip, but it's a one-time trip that you essentially go to this island that will never be seen again, and you can't go back to it. It's a one-shot island. You can take as much stuff as you want, as much stuff as your pockets can fit, and then that's it. And I've been seeing the possibilities there. I'm like, oh man, this is the best time to get like fruit that you haven't had before, or like items, or meet people that you haven't met before. I mean, the possibilities are endless. Three, 4 days ago, if you asked me, like, you know, hey, Sinvicta, what's Animal Crossing? I was like, dude, I don't know. Some weird, like, furry animal villager simulation game. Like, you know, it's like, I can understand the appeal for certain types of people, but I don't think I'm one of them. And now I'm like, dude, I gotta get me some turnips. After talking to Ryan on the NLSS today, talking about turnips and stuff, they actually do have a stock market. I'm like, yo. We're talking actual stocks here. I'm in. I'm all in. Let's do this, you know. But this ain't Animal Crossing. This is Isaac. Eternal Heart here is going to certainly be something. What I really would like to do, I don't know why I made that move. We got lucky that we didn't get clipped there. I thought for sure that we were going to get hit. Mom's wig is, I mean, it's acceptable. One of the little sissy starting items for sure. They get some points for that, but, you know, it's a sad state of affairs when you're using the bean of all things to cause damage. The bean and shade. You know, Flatworm might be okay for these purposes alone, just because we have more surface area to work with. And I don't necessarily want a whole lot of Eternal Hearts. I will say that Head of the Keeper and Pop is a very interesting mechanic. It's almost hypnotizing in a way if you just sit there and look at the coins as they kind of flutter and just sit, they just hover in the air. And that trinket, I know that you. It looks like Flat Penny, but it's not. It's actually Flat Worm. Flat Worm basically just gives you just wider tiers. It's all it doesn't correlate with the whole, like, you know, bigger tiers equals more damage. It has no impact on the damage itself. It just gives you a wider hitbox to work with on your tiers. I mean, like, the larger the tiers, the easier it is for you to hit the enemy. The game paused there, and I wasn't sure if it was freezing or not, and we bombed ourselves out of a soul heart. Pretty happy about that. Shout out to the computer, of course. Thank you for showing up and showing why you're awesome. By awesome, I mean not at all awesome.
Sinvicta, when are you getting a new computer, you nerd? I'm tired of seeing everything stutter.
I don't know if you knew this or not, Thrall, but There's some bigger things going on right now than worrying about whether or not my computer is going to be able to be fixed or not. It's going to take a while, to say the least. I'm still planning on doing it. I definitely want to. All I'm saying is, if I can't get a humidifier that I purchased on Amazon until like April 21st, the chance of me getting a new computer shipped anytime this year is, I'm going to just call it right now. It's shot in the dark, and who's to blame? I am so for multiple reasons why I'm angry that shot not only hit us but also cost us one full heart. On top of that, we paid money for that soul heart too. So our time is nigh. Our time is nay. Is it nay or nigh? Time is now to get a major damage upgrade. Magic Mush, I'm feeling it. I can feel it in my bones. Maybe it's just the coughing. I'm feeling a magic must drop here. Don't know why. We're just dropping the big toots on Gurgi. She can't handle it. I think that's what's so infuriating about getting hit by a nub is that, like, with the amount of projectiles that Gurgi fires on top of her flies, of all things to be hit in this fight, is one of her random nub shots. Is like, ugh. Pre-recorded. It's all pre-recorded. I mean, can he call it or what? They said it couldn't be called. Magic Mush, how you doing? I don't know why. I felt it. I felt like we were gonna get a Magic Mush drop, and lo and behold, it's all pre-recorded. Of course, we all know it's not pre-recorded. But if you are still one of the dissenters and one of the people who actually do believe that these are all pre-recorded, I would like to pose to you a counter question. Why do you think that I would ever want to watch one of my runs twice? On top of that, not only do that, but also play it once and then go back and commentate over me playing it. I'm not in this business to work harder. That's not working smarter, that's working harder. I have no desire to see the same Isaac run twice, let alone commentate my own runs over it. I don't mind commentating someone else's runs. And this is something that, like, I've always toyed around with the thought of doing, but not, like, seriously. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I was going to try to work it somehow back in the Patreon coaching days. Where I would, you know, doing the Isaac coaching and whatnot, I was down for that. And then I thought, well, you know, maybe people would like seeing some plays being broken down, you know, and I was like, well, maybe people would like seeing that kind of thing on YouTube. But then I started to kind of kill the idea just because I was like, yeah, but if someone sends me, like, videos, like, it's sort of, I guess, along the lines of Seed League Heroes, except it's not towards me, it's more towards, like, people submitting videos, where I would go back and do some analyzation of saying, like, hey, you know, was this a good play? Was that a good play or whatever? I think that it would give the wrong impression on people. And on top of that, I don't think that some people are genuinely wanting to have their play not only analyzed by me, but also the entirety of, you know, the mosh pit or the Isaac community. You know, because not only do I not consider myself an expert, there's going to be tons of different ways and styles that you could do stuff. Now, I'm willing to answer questions in a video, like saying, like, if someone submits me a clip or something, they say, hey, what could I have done differently here in this room or whatever, then, yeah, sure, I can help out with that. But in terms of making it, like, an actual, like, legitimate, like, this is something that people want to see series on YouTube, I don't think it's possible. Unless if I was doing it in, like, a sarcastic, like, I'm going to roast you sort of ways, you know? Which I'm not. I think hopefully everyone knows by now I'm not that type of dude to just openly roast people. Now, I'll roast people. Don't get me wrong. I'm fully capable of roasting people. But that's only if they bring a certain level of disrespect or something, you know, this side of the train tracks, you know what I mean? I'm just not going to openly roast people that aren't my friends for no reason at all. Golden Bomb, we might as well take it. If for anything, so we can get into the store. We've already been in the store. Never mind. Yeah, I do not want number two. I do not want Ares. Do not want Mr. Boom. Definitely do not want my reflection. Because it's so ugly. I wish I could get a different reflection. I actually don't really want that. Spider Bite's pretty good. Yeah, we'll take Spider Bite. I'm okay with Spider Bite.
Then, Invicta, you should have taken Roid Rage, you nerd. Why didn't you take it?
Yeah, we could have had Spun, maybe, but our movement speed's already way too high, and I was hoping that we would get another all stats up. Or at least, at the very least, some kind of damage upgrade. We can at least peep what's inside of the boss trap room real fast here. Yeah, I'd say it's probably worth it. Yeah, I'd say it's definitely worth it. Absolutely. Cubby's head, of course, is going to spawn a couple of flies. Oh, that's so good. Pay to Win's also going to give us a reroll machine, a guaranteed reroll machine, in every single item room that we get for the rest of the run, which is basically just two more, unless we get the Bloody Crown, which we don't have right now. And even if we did, we wouldn't be able to keep it at the same time as we had with the Pay to Win. Now, Guppy's head is going to spawn flies every time that we get a full charge. It could be 1 to 3, possibly 4 flies if you're lucky. And they operate off of our base damage, which you can see right here is very, very good. You combine that with the lovely effects of the attack spiders from Mom's Wig, and all of a sudden we've got ourselves a decently powerful run. I think to a certain degree some people would enjoy getting roasted, like for Isaac play and whatnot, but I don't like doing that. I know that's in the spirit of things, like, you know, you want to be a little bit mean, a little bit nasty to people, you know, but I just don't like doing it. I mean, I don't even like hearing people argue, let alone, like, you know, talking down to somebody. And yes, yesterday I could have picked up Mom's Coin Purse while having starter deck, but I didn't. Here's something you can roast me for. I publicly embarrassed myself in the most hilarious way yesterday, last night actually. It's weird to say that because, like, it just happened maybe like 20 minutes ago before I started recording this. Mr. Edmund McMillan, creator of this fine franchise, he tweeted out some awesome new concept art for Isaac for Rebirth. And while he was going through, or it may have been for the original Isaac, I'm not sure. Either way, he tweeted out some old art that he drew when he was coming up and conceptualizing some other enemies in Isaac. And one of them is the jumping spider, the Isaac head jumping spider, the one that everyone, like, you know, really, really hates. The ones that are capable of doing super jumps. Well, underneath that spider's name, I read it as Lulz Spider, so like L-U-L-Z Spider. That's what it looked like. I mean, it looked like Lulz Spiders. And so I tweeted at Ed, and I said, I simultaneously love and hate how its name was Lulz Spiders, because, like, you know, it sort of like signified, like, okay, they wanted these spiders to be just a giant jerk, doing those random, you know, super jumps and blah, blah, blah. So, it made sense. Like, you know, kinetically, man, this is rough. I'm not going to take either because I want to just roll both. Thinking Shears is good, but D12, how you doing? I'll take butt bombs. You know, but in my mind, canonically, like, it made sense. By definition, I was like, yeah, I would name those Lulz Spider because, like, you know, it must be fun for someone. It's not fun for me. It must be fun for the game. Well, then Ed corrected me a couple minutes later. He said, that's actually level 2 Spider. And I had to reread his reply to me like 4 times. I was like, what the heck is he talking about? And then I realized that the name that he had written underneath that spider was supposed to be level 2, like LVL with a number 2, not LULZ. But I think in my defense, I'll pause for a moment while you all are still laughing and giggling. I'll wait. No, that's all right. Just get it all out. That's what I'm here for. If you can't laugh at me, then, you know, you're going to laugh at someone else who may not be able to take it. So that's fine. No. Please continue. Yeah, no, it is funny, yeah. Okay. All right, so, nope. All right, we'll just wait for a little bit. Okay, good. All laughing's out. We got all the giggles out of the way. Okay. Now, in my defense, it is indiscernible, in my opinion, from being a U or a V. And if that's the argument, then fine, I'll accept that. But you can't tell me that looked like LVL. The two or a Z, that was a pretty sharp looking Z. I'm just saying. Who am I to question the man? But hopefully you can at least appreciate where I got the idea from. I almost went down there without looking at our store. that would have been a terrible roast. I should have saved the picture, and then I could have just been like, you know, showing it to you all instead of just describing it. That doesn't really matter. I will take the Soul Heart. Of course, Horror Babylon and Spirit of the Night are two excellent upgrades for us. Alright, we got Magic Mush. We're only... We've got a lot of good stuff going here. Half-price Book of Shadows is not what I'm looking for. Guppy's Head is going to provide us with better safety than that. There's our sponge transformation. With diamonds. Okay, so I will take Euthanasia now. And I will absolutely take Sin Robes. And I suppose I will also have to take a Guppy item. Now we have to see if we can get Guppy. That's going to be another two of diamonds. Okay, so... Didn't actually mean to pick that up, but all right. So we're one Guppy item away now. We would need 14 cents to buy it in a store, unless it was on sale. Yeah, we kind of have to. Not for the Guppy item, but just for the money. Chaos is an item that's going to shuffle up all the loot tables. I'm sure it's an item you've heard me talk about before. I don't usually take Chaos. Under certain circumstances, I will, or at least I have been known to take Chaos. Not always true. In this case, with us having two Guppy items, yeah, it looks like a great play. But before we got in the second Guppy item, it's kind of like, I could take it or leave it, because... The reason why, if you're asking, well, how come you wouldn't? Like, what's the downside of taking Chaos then? The downside of taking Chaos is simply that it dilutes the Devil Deal item pool, especially if you've already have a deal with the Devil Precedent. So, theoretically, the idea there is that you are robbing yourself out of Devil Deal items, because now instead of you getting Devil Deal items in the Devil Deal, you can get any kind of items in the Devil Deal. Like, it's still going to cost you HP to get these items, but now we have basically made it... We've basically made it almost, like, guaranteeable that we will not see a Devil Deal item ever inside of a Devil Deal. Now, of course, the trade-off for that is that, well, we can get Devil Deal items in other areas, like, say, the shop, for example. You know, so that, it's give and take. There's definitely risk and rewards built into it. I don't know what happened to that tier right there. I'm just gonna just let it happen. I feel like Euthanasia probably had something to deal with that. So this room is like the easiest room ever because we can just simply shoot through. What is going on with these tiers? Okay, yeah, just randomly rotten baby sitting there. Cool. Randomly rotten baby was my favorite. Early 90s punk album. I've never been into punk. Punk has always felt like contemporary rock to me. By contemporary, I mean like almost like old school rock, except like more more punkish, almost more ska-ish, I guess. And ska is definitely not a genre of music I enjoy at all. I've heard ska. I guess I can see the appeal of it for certain people, but it's just not for me.
What do you mean by certain people, Invicta?
I mean, I understand why people would like it. I just don't like it. It's not my jam, literally. Yeah, we already have Spectre Tears here. Book a shadow for the second time. I guess we'll just go ahead and pick that up. Yeah. I can get a little Athame. Great dodge right there. Yeah, so if you're wondering where all these tears are coming from, the little explosions that you're seeing, that's coming from Euthanasia, which does the Tammy's Head effect every time it procs. Now, why it's making all the tears flip out like that because we have Pop, I have no idea. But this Two of Diamonds card that we have is very, very crucial here. Assuming that we don't get a greed fight inside of our store, which I most likely just jinxed myself with. But potentially, this Two of Diamonds could be huge because of Chaos. Athame, as you see right there, if we ever take a hit, we'll do a retaliatory Black Brimstone Ring, which deals a good amount of damage and also has a pretty high chance of paying out with a Soul Heart. One of the better items in the Double Deal pool. Did not get a greed fight. Even more rare, we did get a reroll machine. Okay, so what we're looking for now, not that. Man. Mama Mega could get us into Boss Rush.
Two of Diamonds.
Which could lead us to a Guppy item. Right now, the whole point of this is Guppy. That's all we're looking for at this point. Man, Mulligan's tough, but I mean, if we get Guppy, we'll have the Mulligan. That's key, not good enough. Sharp Straw is fantastic, but not what we're looking for. That's disappointing. I don't think this is 2020. How many books have we touched? We did not touch the... Obviously, we touched the Book of Shadows. We did not touch the Jump Cartridge or Telepathy for Dummies. But I think this is only our second book here. And honestly, I'm going to stick with Guppy's Head. Our damage is high enough to where that's in my opinion, that's an adequate choice. But if you're playing along and you're a little less trusting of this run, you could absolutely take whatever we were taking there. Sad bombs and all right, so it wasn't worth it in the end. But yeah, if you're unsure of what to do in this run, and you just weren't convinced that your damage would keep you safe, or if for whatever reason you have any shortcomings about this run, Satanic Bible would ease that passing a little bit here. A very carefully take. All right, no deal with the devil. That's okay.
That's okay, Sinvictor. Are you feeling okay?
Yeah, I'm feeling fine. Also, the reason why I said that's okay without a deal with the devil is because, remember, we have Chaos. So we don't necessarily care about getting deals with the devil now, because chances are we're not going to get a devil deal inside of that devil deal. The whole thing I was talking about, 8 minutes ago. Invert Cursed and Rocked. I almost said Cursed Rock. Which I'm sure we'll see plenty of those in the in Repentance. I am going to be I'm going to feel a little bit slighted here if we don't get Guppy. Okay, this is going to be a dead end here. All right, so again, those of you playing along, if you happen to be trailing behind me, just know that north, east, and west are not the correct directions to go on this map. And you should go south. When in doubt, go south, what I say. That's a good old-fashioned Texan saying here. When in doubt, you just go south. Just see what you just see wherever the wind takes you. I am happy living in the south. I think that there is something to the whole southern hospitality thing in a non-ludicrous sort of way. For those of you who happen to be a Zoomer, Ludacris had a early hit called Southern Hospitality. One of his earlier tracks. That was very good. Look it up, sweetheart. Also, don't look it up without your parents' permission. Got some pretty explicit lyrics in it. Anyway. But no, I think there's something to the whole Southern Hospitality thing. You know, people are just nice down here. You know, it's very, very common for people who you don't know to say, you know, hey, you know, good morning, good afternoon, how you doing? Some parts of the world that's not really looked highly upon. Some certain parts of the world consider that rude almost. You go out of your way to ask somebody, hey, how you doing? You know. Or even making like light talk, like small chit chat while you're checking out for the groceries, you know. You find everything good, okay, you know. The clerk, she may notice that you bought a lot of like meat. I didn't even see that red poop there. She'd be like, oh, having a barbecue today, huh? So yeah, it's, you know, Super Bowl Sunday, everyone usually does that. And then she says, like, you know, oh, that's cool, who are you rooting for? I was like, well, I mean, you know, my team's the Buccaneers, and I didn't really, you know, expect them to go in there, and that's why they're not, so. Oh, you like Tampa? Yeah, my cousin's from Tampa. Oh, really? Which part of Tampa she's from? Oh, she's from northern Tampa. Like, oh, that's cool. I mean, I'm not really from Tampa at all, but, like, you know, I could just feign interest like I am. You know, because, I mean, she's kind of cute and all, and, you know, she's trying to, you know, figure out what's going on at the barbecue. So she'll say, like, you know, so what's all this meat for, though? Like, you having a big been shindig? I'm like, yeah, we got a big old shindig happening. I'm inviting some friends over, you know, it's cool. So, you know, you ask her, like, you know, well, you know, if you're not doing anything, you feel like watching some football, come on down. We got plenty of meat. That's what she say. Oh yeah, but yeah, I'm sorry, I'm engaged. I was like, well, I'm not asking you to go out with me. I'm just saying if you wanna hang out, you know, you can bring your fiance. I mean, I don't know him. It's not really cool to bring another dude over if you don't know the dude. But yeah, you know, whatever. I was just trying to be nice, you know. And then you got to deal with the whole consequence of the girl not being able to come over there without her fiance. And then next thing you know, you're all kind of bummed out and you just decide to cancel the barbecue. You play some Animal Crossing New Horizons. You know, just good old Southern hospitality. I know people want me to re-roll. I'm not going to, though. I think that it would do a disservice to Magic Mush, to be honest. That, and I don't want to get stuck with something terrible this late in a run. I will happily accept the assumption that some people may still have that all these are pre-recorded. I know most of the time when someone says that it's a joke. They're going for a jape. They're going for a jab. You know, it's all in good fun. But there are some legitimate people who think that these are all pre-recorded still. And again, I'm just like, man, I wish I had that kind of time. I mean, I have that kind of time, but I wish I had that kind of like, yeah, I'm going to put that much effort into making sure that the Isaac content's coming out. And it's got to be error-free. To which I will also present the argument to you, for those of you who may still actually seriously think that these are still pre-recorded. Do you think I would make the same mistakes, or I'd allow myself to make the same oversights without having to explain myself when they happen? You would think that if I was pre-recording these, I would at least be like, you know, saying, oh yeah, so the reason why I didn't take mom's coin purse here is because I didn't want the mom transformation, even though I know we had starter deck. No. You kidding me? I go like 3 or 4 episodes back to explain myself if somebody asked me about it in the comments. Certain, I mean, there's a lot of people ask a lot of questions.
A whole lot.
And if you want to ask some questions this week, make sure you use the hashtag humidifier. Act now, and you know, I might even answer more than one question.
Oh, there's a fly there.
I mean, we have the moon card, and we might as well use it. All right, and use it we shall. And how? No, 2 years. 2 years of an Eden streak is just. I mean, I cannot describe what it means to me because I don't know what it means to me. I really don't. The streak is important, but it's not that important to me. What's important for me is growing the channel, doing things. You know, and what I would perceive, hopefully, as the right thing, the right way of doing stuff here. You know, keeping my nose clean, staying out of other people's business, and just cultivating and growing the mosh pit for what it is. Try to keep people entertained, try to find new games that people may not have seen before. That's all, that's more important to me than a winning streak, than a number. Even like, we're talking about sub numbers, we're talking about like, not only sub numbers, but like views and stuff. I mean, there was a point on YouTube where I was like, man, like, you know, if we don't get 1,000 views on this Heroes of the Storm video, like, I'm never gonna play again. Like, I've never ever had that attitude towards numbers, ever. And I would usually defy my own rationalization of. What could be perceived as good or a bad idea on YouTube in terms of numbers, like the fact that Isaac was pulling in like maybe 80 views, 70 to 80 views per video. Not 70 to 80,000, 70 to 80 views per video. It's chaos. I can't do it. I can't do it. I can, but I'm not going to. No, Isaac was driving people away from the channel, and I didn't care. I didn't care. It's the one thing that I didn't listen. I've never listened to Husky about. It's the one time I defied what he suggested for me to do. He was just giving me, you know, brotherly advice, just saying, hey, you need to stop playing this Binding of Isaac game because it's actually making people unsub. I'm like, dude, I know it's killing my channel. I know, but like, I need something else to play. In a weird way, I can thank Heroes of the Storm for making Isaac what it is today. Because had I not hated Heroes of the Storm so much during the times of me doing solo queue silliness, I would have not needed a game like Isaac to take as a vacation. At least in Isaac, I could relax. Win or lose, I could be like, yes, I'm not playing solo queue silliness. Thank God. Thank Christ for that. I do not want to be doing any part of solo key silliness, any game but Heroes of the Storm. And I don't look, despite saying all that, despite taking jabs at Blizzard, back when I was doing Heroes of the Storm content, like it's just a different company now. It's not, I don't even look at Blizzard as the Blizzard that I knew and worked with on a professional level. It's not the same to me. So I don't feel bad sliding it now. But back then, I was working with some awesome people at Blizzard. I had friends that were working there for years and years and years. You know, I will never be able to replace the memories that I was given by Blizzard. Doing the Mayhem Begins event, the opening for the worldwide release for Heroes of the Storm coming out of closed beta and open beta, was still one of the highlights of my life. I've never felt like I had been so close to making it, quote making it, as an entertainer until then. And being on the main stage and, you know, and meeting everybody. I mean, that's, you know, I owe I owed a lot to Heroes of the Storm. I don't look back with unpleasant memories. I do look at my experience playing the game with unpleasant memories. In terms of, like, solo queue, because, man. Now, do I think that Heroes of the Storm is a great game? No, I don't. I don't think that it's a great game. It could have been great. But do I resent or regret my time and the role that I spent playing that game? No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. I would. There are millions of people around who would have loved to have been there. Who would have loved to go to get paid to go to the YouTube space in LA to do an official opening for a Blizzard game. I mean, how cool is that? How many people can in the world can say that they were part of a global launch for a major Blizzard game launch? They were there, like they were paid by Blizzard to be there. Not many, and I'm very proud of that. You know, and again, it's one of those fond memories that I have. I don't enjoy what Blizzard has become these days. You know, I don't have any real ties that work there anymore. I mean, they're long gone. The Blizzard of 2020 and really 2018 and beyond is not the same Blizzard back in 2014 and 15 and 16. You know, and I still have contact. I still speak to my old Blizzard friends every now and then, even when they're still not with the company. But it's because they're generally cool people. Genuinely some of the smartest, most talented, and awesome people that I've ever met have worked at Blizzard. They just don't anymore. So I don't know what that says about anything, but... Yeah, so thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. No questions for today. Just thank you all very much for all the support. And I'm glad that people are looking forward to, cautiously optimistic about the blacklisted items week. I know that people are worried about it, but I'm not. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Really quickly here, and answering a couple of fast questions before we hop on out of here. Somebody asked, Ganon asked, for blacklist runs, will you be dropping spacebar items for blacklisted items too, or are they exempt? No. If I have a spacebar item and something else is better, then I will hold on to that. But if it's a blacklisted spacebar item, I pretty much have to take that. So hopefully that makes sense. So if I have like the Book of Shadows and like Kamikaze shows up, I don't have to use Kamikaze, but I have to take it in that spot. If that makes sense. So it's a good question there. One more question. I'm trying to scroll through the queries here. And Jacob asked, do pills count for blacklisted week? Pills do not count because they're not items. There you go. And one final one here, just because it just happens to be on the screen here. Jibble Wolf asked, in blacklisted week, would you have to take pills as well, seeing as pills are big no-no without PhD or Virgo? Again, taking pills, I'm not planning on doing it unless I have PhD or Virgo. And pills don't count. So it's a common thread there. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your Thursday. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.